So what's so super about superconductivity?
The wise guy Matt Sullen is here to show us, and he joins us now live from his lab. Good morning, Matt.
Hi, Mike. Hi, Gay. So we can demonstrate some very interesting properties of superconductors, but let me just give you a little information first. People realized, I guess, quite a long time ago that when you make something colder, it conducts electricity better. They understood atoms and electrons and so on. But you couldn't make things very cold until people learned how to liquefy helium. Now, this liquid nitrogen stuff that we've been playing around with, that's about 77 degrees above absolute zero. If you could liquefy helium, what happens is that liquid is about just a couple of degrees above absolute zero. And in 1908, a German physicist, Onis, figured out how to do this stuff. And just 3 years later, he discovered superconductivity in his lab. Because what he did was he took various metals, things like mercury, tin, and lead, and so on, made them very, very cold. And he saw that if you make them cold enough, a couple of degrees Kelvin, basically the resistance goes away. Currents flow forever. It doesn't just get small, the resistance actually goes to absolutely zero, which is phenomenally interesting.
So what's that in Fahrenheit, Matt?
That's about, that's a good question. Yeah, I can tell you in Celsius, it's about 300 below.
Wow.
I mean, so about 370. Now you got me on the spot. It's cold. It's zero.
We really talk cold.
Degrees here in this lab. So anyways, what can we do with this stuff? So one thing you can do is it has interesting magnetic properties. Let me just show you. Here's a coil of wire, and here's a little current meter. If I take a magnet and I stab it into this coil, you see the little meter moving there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens is if I move a magnet near a conductor, you've got a current flowing, but because this thing is not a superconductor, the current stops right away. So the needle just jiggles over a little bit, and then it goes back. What I can do is here in this little dish that we're going to put the camera on, what I have is a superconductor. Now, I haven't mentioned this, but in the 80s, people discovered how to make things that superconduct at a much higher temperature so that you only need to get them as cold as liquid nitrogen for them to be perfect conductors. So this little black disc, which is in the bottom of this styrofoam cheesy cup with the liquid nitrogen in it, is right now superconducting. It has no resistivity, whatever. Right here, I have a little magnet.
Okay.
If I bring this magnet close like this, what happens is that I get currents flowing around inside that superconductor, but because the superconductor is perfect, those currents are now flowing forever. They keep going, and when currents flow, you generate a magnetic field, and it turns out that the field that is generated by the currents that are flowing inside the superconductor point in the opposite direction to the magnet that I put on there, so it repels it, it levitates it.
Wow.
Isn't that cool?
That is really cool.
So right now there are these supercurrents, little vortices of current flowing inside the superconductor, and this thing would just float above that forever. And I can spin it like that. And the interesting thing is, with these kinds of superconductors, these are called high-temperature superconductors, the magnetic field lines that come out of this magnet, okay, they kind of get stuck into this material, so this thing doesn't fall off. If you just took two fridge magnets and you try to balance one on the other, it would always fall off. But these things get stuck on there, so this thing is basically, the field lines get stuck, the currents are perpetual, they'll flow forever, so this thing will just sit on top of there and spin around as long as we wanted it to. Isn't that interesting?
That really is cool.
That's amazing. That was really neat.
So next week, we're going to talk a little bit more about what happens when currents flow in metals, what happens when you bring magnets close to wires and so on, and we have some interesting demonstrations for that. So we'll see you then.
We look forward to that. Thanks. Matt Sullen, live on the University of Illinois campus. Well, let's take a look live outside now through our